Welcome back to another episode of Sake Drinker and Friends. We are at Morimoto Napa, Momosan Bar proper, where we do everything sake and Japanese and everything you could imagine. Today we have a very exciting show in a rainy day in the middle of the first week of March, right? Super exciting. We have a chef that's our neighbor, very dear to our heart, that actually worked with us here at Morimoto, and he's up to do great things. Chef Itamar, welcome to the show. It's such a treat to have you. Please welcome. Chef Itamar is heading the kitchen and has an amazing team over at the Kitchen Collective. If you guys haven't heard of it, it's a sort of a club where you can come and cook for your friends. But who better to tell us than Chef Itamar?
So Kitchen Collective, we started about 6 months ago, roughly. We're still in soft launch mode, so we're not quite open. It's a members only club. Think of a country club, take away the golf and tennis, and put in kitchen hospitality. So we have this beautiful kitchen that, when it was first built, they spent quite a few millions of dollars on just building the kitchen itself.
It was Budo, right?
It was Budo,
and then Cuvée,
and then the hotel administered it for a few years, and then we came along and spent about a week cleaning it.
Nice.
But it's fully stocked with everything you can imagine. All the food that I brought in today is actually stuff that I just had in the pantry. So you have a full pantry and you can just come in and play. Whatever it is you want to cook. I mean, on Wednesday night we're going to have someone cooking Japanese food.
Nice.
They're going to try and roll sushi. We're going to have one person cooking duck a l'orange. Wow. And we're going to have a third doing pizzas in a wood burning oven. So all that together is just giving you the opportunity to have fun with hosting. So
wow, and actually to mention that this last Saturday, you guys hosted a Trifecta Cooks, so it's a pop-up. And I was honored to be invited and help a little bit with the sake pairings for the dinner. And it's pretty exciting. I love what you guys are doing. Garrett, Marsha, the whole team is pretty lively and exciting.
Yeah, they are. It's really, really fun. And the Trifecta Cooks are all guys that I actually met when I worked here. They were working out of the sushi line or the hot side, and we stayed good friends since.
Beautiful.
So they are now doing their own thing, and whenever we at Kitchen Collective can support our community, we bring them on to do a pop-up, which is something that we do a lot. I'm actually going to host you. We're going to do together a pop-up soon.
Yes, we are very excited that we're going to actually collaborate on a menu, and we'll have a good amount of people come and enjoy chef's cuisine as you will today via camera or on the stage.
Please enjoy here and tell them how good it is.
Absolutely. And also just have an exciting challenge pairing sake and maybe a little bit of wine or something. Never know what's going to come.
We're going to do sake non-Japanese.
Exactly. Well, without further ado, I'd like to start with sake because that's what we do, right?
It's a
sake drinker and friend show. So this is pretty exciting, and I'm not going to lie, I had a heads up on the first dish you brought, Chef. You brought three dishes.
I did.
And this sake, I think, is going to be an amazing pairing for the first part. This is a sake from Wakayama Prefecture, which is mostly known for growing fruits. So a tropical, warm region of Japan in the south. But they managed to make this amazing sake. It's an extra dry style, something we're not totally used to in the U.S. especially. People here in the U.S., a lot of us tend to start with a little sweeter style of sake, or cloudy, if you will. But this is the closest to a sincere style, with a lot of imagination, of course. But let me pass a little for the audience. And if you don't mind, Chef, we'll get along with the food.
Yeah, so with this, I'm going to go with fried. I'm going to go with, so this is a dish that is from my home country of Israel. It is fried cauliflower on house-made labneh with za'atar.
If I may, I'll show everybody what Chef's talking about.
So I took the cauliflower, deep-fried it, and then some salt on it. We made yogurt, and then we strained it for a week. So we get this beautiful tartness that will balance really, really well with the fruitiness of this sake, I think. So we'll see what it looks like.
Absolutely. Let's give it a whirl and pass them around. And,
yes.
Please, guys in the audience,
enjoy.
Always enjoy responsibly. If you are driving or working, take little
then
sips.
Just have the food.
Exactly. So, if you don't mind, I'm going to go ahead and try this beauty that I've been smelling for a bit. And looks amazing.
So you wanna, yeah, you wanna get the labneh in there as well. So it's a wiping motion.
Wow, that's extremely delicate, soft, and crisp on the outside, and it's got this sting of citrus. That's really outstanding. Wow, yeah. I really enjoy it. My mouth's watering.
And it's bringing out the fruitiness in this sake, which I really like. Oh, some sake is like light.
Yes, it's kind of light on its feet, like a big guy doing ballet, right? Kind of thing.
That is the image that I had in mind, yeah.
What do the audience think of the dish and the pairing?
Delicious.
I'll be honest, please, not because Chef's here.
Yeah.
All right? I am going to have another piece of this beauty.
Go for it.
Wow, I could eat this, the sauce and everything.
This, yeah, the labneh is really fun to make, and we use it for everything.
Mm-hmm.
It goes in Greek cuisine, and it goes in American, and it goes in everything. It's just a really nice, think of Greek yogurt, a bit more tart.
Totally. I'm going to stop by Kitchen Collective, get a whole tub of that for home. If you don't
Please
mind.
Do.
You tell me when. By the way, Chef made an amazing eggnog. First time Chef Maya and I visited Kitchen Collective, he twisted her arm to try it, and it was outstanding.
Yeah,
and then
I'm known for being the escalator. You show up in the middle of the day, and all of a sudden you get a 40% eggnog.
Oh my God, it really blew your socks off, but amazing. So let's move on to the next sake, and the next dish, first of all.
So our next dish is...
So remarkably beautiful before anything.
Thank you. I brought you some flowers.
Thank you, Chef. Quite thoughtful for the occasion.
Yeah. So we have one of our members is Peter Jacobson, who is almost exclusively growing at his farm in Yonkville for the French Laundry. And we have a great opportunity of just having access to his produce. And right now, this is all cover crop in Napa Valley. So even though it is rainy, spring feels like it has sprung.
Absolutely.
There's flowers all over. And if I had to call this dish anything, it would be a bouquet of carpaccio.
Nice.
So it's just whatever cover crop we have. There's some arugula, there's some mustard, there's some fava. A whole bunch of different flowers that I just wrapped in dry aged tenderloin.
Beautiful.
That we dry aged in house.
No, that is. I almost don't want to eat it. I would love to have my phone to take a picture of it. But let's try with one of my favorite sakes. This is a sake from the south, Kubota Manju. It is a Junmai Ginjo, and I love it because it's a little oxidated but gentle. It's like let's say a pretty rough UFC fighter with some velvet gloves, in a way, if you will. I've never used that one before, but that's what it reminds me of. And let's try the sake if you like. Cheers.
Cheers. Oh, wow. Wow. Definitely floral. Definitely dry.
Yes. It ends really dry. It
really
kind of
dry.
Tightens up.
Nice acidity on it, which should go really, really well with flowers.
Totally. If I may pass some around, and for the new guest as well. Thank you, sir. That way, everybody gets the whole experience. And please, Chef. Oh,
flowers for you.
Thank you so much. Wow, I can't wait to try this. Wow. Talk about flavorful flowers. It's got the bitterness of dandelions, watercress, arugula.
Now you're getting a bit of spice at the end from the actual arugula rub that's in there. And
wow, I have no words.
Thank you.
It's not only beautiful, but it just delivers. Wow. Wow, it just keeps going. The pairing, I think the beauty of this pairing is that the sake has this strength as we taste it, kind of richer and dry.
It's robust.
Exactly. So it kind of hugs it a bit.
Yeah.
It doesn't overpower the sake. And I got to say, this dish has a lot of the bitterness. It just keeps going.
Yeah, it's really lingering. I would say a lot of times when I pair food to wine or to sake, I try to showcase the drink. In this specific dish, I'm gonna say that the sake actually brings out more flavors in the dish. So it feels more herbaceous, more robust in flavor of the dish itself.
Wow.
Than earlier with the labneh dish.
Uh-huh.
The sake came out prettier. Now the dish is elevated by the sake.
Yeah, which that's remarkable. And quite different, both different dishes.
Completely different.
Outstanding. Great job, chef. Those are amazing. Well, without further ado, let's move on to the next.
We are going to move on to the next one. So,
wow.
About the beauty of Kitchen Collective is that it allows me to play with food. So I don't repeat dishes. So over here in a restaurant, you get to do the same dish over and over and perfect it.
Absolutely.
The chances of us repeating a dish at Kitchen Collective are really low, because you might come in tomorrow and make steak and fries, and the next day you're not going to want to repeat steak and fries as our member.
No.
So you'll make something different. And with our members, we bounce around. So this one day we had a pork shoulder left over. And we decided to try and cure it and make copa.
Nice.
So this was an experiment, and it worked remarkably well.
Wow.
I'm really proud of it.
There is only one thing I can think of for this style of dry cured meat, especially copa. It's got all the spices. And what's the rub you did on it?
Wow, I can't even remember. There's paprika, cayenne, chili flakes, cumin, coriander. There's a bit of honey, a bit of sugar, and I sprinkled some rosemary flowers on this. And
I can smell the aromas. It's really, really out there. For all of you watching us all over the world, in Russia and Africa and wherever else you're enjoying some sake, wow, that is amazing. Something that might be worth emailing you for the recipe there, chef. So beware, and please put your helmets and your seatbelts for the sake. This is a really extreme style of sake. We've had it on the show before. Briefly, this is called inemankai, and it's a red rice. It starts with almost purplish, and they mill it down, not a fully 30%, but they add a little burst alcohol, and they do it in a very artisanal style. So it brings out some notes I could only compare to an orange wine from northern Italy, or maybe a wine from Georgia.
If I would not know this sake and just smelling it, I would say an aged
Syrah.
Yeah,
there is a Cordon tea aspect to this wine. If you're into northern Rhone style of Syrah,
yes.
There's pepper, there's cotton candy, there's plenty of blood, there's like a leathery quality to it. But I mean, let's give it a quick taste to it. The remarkable part is once you taste it, it is completely different.
Yeah. Wow, this is. I did not expect that.
No, not at all.
You never seem to amaze me.
Right? So, I mean, I only thought this would work together, and let's prove it if it does or doesn't. I don't know if there'll be plenty for the whole audience, since I'm gonna help myself here. Daniel, thank you, sir.
I'm really glad I went on a quick decision and put some honey on the cook.
Mm-hmm. Actually, yeah, that pops a little bit. There's a little sweetness in there.
That works really, really well together. That was a really good pairing. You never cease to amaze me.
Wow. Chef, that is money. That is a really fun pairing. This sake, it could only work with something like that. The nature of sake, naturally, historically, obviously, is to pair with the Japanese cuisine, whether it's fish or fried or sweeter dishes. But, because I've been to Japan only once last year, but I didn't come across any dry cured meats anywhere. There's not a lot of Italian cuisine. So it is fun to find something reaching cultures, two of my favorite cultures, the Italian and the Japanese. And
there you go.
Wow.
Well, if you make something well, it goes well. You can't really go wrong.
That is a true statement right there. Wow.
This is really well made.
The audience approves?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Is there something that pops out of there? That's good.
What's balance? Favorite? Some votes on favorites.
Yes, you can whistle, clap, scream.
The cauliflower.
Nice.
The sake.
This sake definitely packs a punch, and for all of you big Cabernet drinkers, that would be something like it.
Yeah.
It does end with a little sweetness, Wow, but that thing just... I'm going to have amazing dreams with this pairing right here. Wow. That is truly fun.
I hardly ate anything.
I know. Well, please. I am going to go to town. With that, we end the show, and we want to thank the audience. We want to thank Chef, the Kitchen Collective, everybody that's helped us. And cheers, guys. Kanpai. Until next time, we're here.
Thank you for having us.
Cheers. Thank you.